Hi, I am Cesar Santos. How to achieve whatever you want in life. The other day, I was reading in a Law of Attraction book a quote that said, that what you desire desires you back. And even though there is some truth to that sentence, I want to take a closer look and analyze it and see how we can take advantage of that idea a little bit better. If you want something in life, that doesn't mean automatically that you will attract it. And that is what got me thinking. Let's say if you want a glass of water, that doesn't mean that automatically the glass of water will be available or will be coming to you. You have to do something about it. And just to use that glass of water metaphor, because it's simple, the moment you feel that you're thirsty, you imagine the glass of water, so you're already thinking about it. There's a way to attract it, but you have to go forward, make some action, and organize it, put it together so you can drink the water. Focus your attention on that which you desire and take physical action to go and make it a reality. In that action that you took, you actually made some sacrifices because you avoided everything else around you. By envisioning what you needed to do, you were able to just aim at that and make it a reality. And you avoided other things around it. So in a way, that is a sacrifice. You had to spend energy going and getting it. If you follow the right steps, the step-by-step process to get to that goal, you will make it then a reality. When I looked at that phrase that said, that what you desire desires you back. Another example might be, let's say you like someone, you're interested in an individual and you desire that person, but if you don't take action, if you don't let them know, if you don't make sacrifices to show your affection for that person, they might never know what your intentions are. So in a way, that's another clear example that action is required to attract something in a real way. The law of attraction doesn't really work if you don't take risk, if you're not decisive, if you don't take action and put things in order and make the sacrifice to achieve it, to go for the adventure. So if you want to become a painter, you have to take action in order to achieve that goal. You have to think that you have to develop your craft, make sacrifices, learn where the best information is and try to have access to it. Because if you stay frustrated, if you find resistance, that sentence at the beginning can be turned around as well. And we can say that that which you resist, resists you back. So I don't recommend having that negative attitude if you're not achieving your goals. Because the thing is that the path that you're taking might not be the right one or might be taking you longer, but never resist. Always try to attract and desire. If you are an artist that had made sacrifices, you've taken the right path, you have gotten far enough in your career and you think that you deserve a little bit more success and you're ready to receive it, then maybe it's time for you to study what success entails. Make sure you're open to learning from successful people, because success that has been achieved by successful people have something in common that we can probably detect and use it in our own lives. For instance, doing high quality work or having a good state of mind, offer value to the people that surround you, to your society. Be kind to people, because that will help you and help everybody work with you. That's why it's so difficult to encompass all, because not only it takes such a long time and dedication to develop your skills, but also then you have to divert your thinking into then what does it take to offer value to society so that they give you the freedom for you to express yourself however you want. Okay, let's wrap this video up. The law of attraction might just be a phrase, but nothing will attract you if you don't push that pace. Okay. Look at this.